Hello, Katherine from WKini here. Welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. What I have for you today are three home remedies that can help you lower your creatinine levels. We are talking about fast results here and proven by science. So first, I'll show you how to use the tremendous benefits of spirulina to help with kidney health. Now, spirulina is something that I use every single day for my health, so I can also tell you exactly what to expect when taking it. So let's start immediately. The first question is, what will happen to your kidneys if you take a tablespoon of spirulina every day before going to sleep? This supplement has several well-documented benefits for your kidneys. Spirulina has been a favorite of health-conscious people for years, or at least since NASA decided to grow it in space for use by astronauts. Today, it is known as being one of the top superfoods in the world. And the reason why I'm recommending it to you right now is because it has been studied on patients suffering from kidney disease just recently. The research was published on Journal of Functional Foods in 2018, and well, what researchers found out about this supplement will surprise you. But let's start from the beginning, shall we? What is spirulina and why is it so popular? Spirulina is classified as a cyanobacteria or blue-green algae. It is not a plant. It is a type of cyanobacteria, a tiny alga that lives in fresh and salt water and produces oxygen through photosynthesis. This means that it's actually loaded with chlorophyll, which helps alkalize your body. And you may already know how important it is for someone with kidney problems to eat alkalizing foods. It's also loaded with B vitamins and also minerals like zinc and magnesium. Great for your heart health. In fact, spirulina is being promoted to prevent, treat, or cure a number of conditions including high cholesterol, hypertension, diabetes, depression, and even malnutrition. Moreover, it's said to boost the immune system and improve kidney and liver function. Let's see how many of these benefits are proven by science. First, there is blood sugar control. Animal studies link spirulina to significantly lower blood sugar levels. In some cases, it has outperformed popular diabetes drugs including metformin. Incredible! Spirulina has also been shown to help detoxify your body of heavy metals. In fact, a recent study found that it detoxifies your body of the heavy metal arsenic. Of all the heavy metals, we probably get more arsenic in our diet than anything else. The reason is pesticides in foods. Very dangerous. Arsenic may even cause liver and kidney failure. And spirulina can help. Also, spirulina is a powerful anti-inflammatory. Many antioxidants in spirulina have anti-inflammatory effects in the body. And by the way, this anti-inflammatory effect is the reason why I use it. It's a very noticeable effect, actually. It can reduce the pain from, you know, migraines or arthritis. It's almost comparable in terms of results to the 7 natural remedies to stop any pain instantly of my recent video. And spirulina can help with cholesterol levels too. Pretty useful. What's more, spirulina may be very effective in reducing high blood pressure. According to the study, this can be obtained thanks to an increased production of nitric oxide, a signaling molecule that helps your blood vessels relax and dilate. Now, about what incredible discovery scientists made about this alga. What scientists discovered about spirulina is that it also acts as an antioxidant, helping to protect kidney cells from damage caused by these super reactive molecules called free radicals. They discovered this in a study on rats. We saw rats were administered gentamicin, an antibiotic which induces oxidative stress and renal injury. Rats that also received spirulina received significantly less damage from the high dose of antibiotics. This is really interesting because researchers think that damage done to the kidneys by gentamicin is of oxidative nature, similar to the damage done by oxidative stress in kidney disease. Researchers think that spirulina can prevent this damage by an increased production of nitric oxide, which can also help with blood pressure, as we have seen. This could easily translate in kidney protective effect that we can benefit from. Incredible! Spirulina is available in capsules, tablets, and powder, and has been incorporated in certain foods and beverages such as energy bars and smoothies. If you don't know how to find it, check the link in the description. Now, what dosage of spirulina should you take to get all the health benefits and the protection from oxidative stress? In general, 1 to 8 grams per day of spirulina has been shown to produce benefits, but if you have kidney disease, less is more. I'll show you why in a moment. However, here are the doses. For cholesterol, doses in the range of 1 to 8 grams per day are best. For blood glucose control, effects have been seen with 2 grams per day. For blood pressure, may be affected at doses of 3.5 to 4.5 grams per day. Also, it's advisable to take spirulina in the evening because it stimulates the natural release of melatonin, the hormone that regulates circadian rhythm and helps to sleep. But remember that you need the approval of your doctor to start using this remedy if you have chronic kidney disease, other diagnosed pathologies, or if you are taking prescription drugs. Now, of all the dosages you see here, always consider the lower one. The reason is that spirulina is rich in protein, and people with kidney problems usually benefit from a low protein diet. Although, if we are talking about just 1 teaspoon of this supplement per day, the protein you're going to get is minimal. A fun fact, spirulina turns your mouth green and your urine green. This is normal and okay. Okay guys, I have a question for you now. Have you ever tried spirulina? Is there anything you want to know before trying it? Let's talk about it in comment section. And there are two other very powerful remedies I want to show you today, both very helpful in lowering creatinine levels. Number two is going to be even more interesting than spirulina. If you ever heard about bulletproof coffee or brain octane, they are all made using this ingredient. MCT oil. Just like spirulina, MCT oil is a very powerful home remedy that has recently seen a breakthrough in treating kidney problems. It is extremely useful, especially for people needing to lose weight and those suffering from diabetes. But let's go with order. What is MCT oil? MCT oil is usually sourced from coconut oil, and it's a source of medium chain triglycerides, or MCTs. MCTs are a type of fat that can be readily used for energy by your body. Unlike other more common types of dietary fat, this is extremely useful for people with diabetes or for those wanting to lose weight. The body can use MCT for short-term energy, just like carbohydrates. But unlike carbohydrates, MCT won't cause an insulin spike. Incredible, isn't it? This is absolutely great when it comes to managing insulin resistance and can even help with weight loss. Very interestingly, there are studies that shows how adding MCT to the diet can improve insulin resistance. Yes, people with diabetes can get incredible benefits from this home remedy. So, should people with kidney problems be using MCT oil? Well, it has a long list of health benefits for people with kidney problems. These are all supported by science, as we can tell from the extensive list of researchers I'm listing as source for this. So, what benefits are we talking about? First of all, as we have seen, it has powerful effects on insulin resistance and blood sugar levels. Now, diabetes is the number one cause of kidney disease in the world, and finding ways to treat insulin resistance should be the priority of people with diabetes. The third benefit listed here is helping with weight loss. Researchers think that this effect is both due to the powerful satiating effects of MCT oil and effects on insulin. This is important. Never underestimate body weight as a risk factor. Even if you don't have diabetes, being overweight is extremely dangerous for the kidneys. I have made a video to explain this in detail. It's up here. If you are interested in watching it, consider that, as usual, the video is focused on how to solve the problem. What's more, MCT oil has high amounts of antioxidants that help with curbing inflammation in the body. Very important, if you have kidney problems, in one of the studies published in 2010 in Pharmaceutical Biology, coconut oil helped with inhibiting the rapid spread of chronic inflammatory response in the body. Now, this is an impressive list of benefits for a single supplement. While it's clear that those who will get the most from using MCT oil are people overweight and people with diabetes, no reasons not to consider it even if you're in great shape already. Now you may ask, is MCT oil different from coconut oil? While there is some overlap, they are not the same compounds. MCT oil can actually be derived from coconuts, but it is a much more concentrated compound when compared to coconut oil. MCT oil contains 100% MCTs, whereas coconut oil only contains about 45% to 65% MCTs. And while coconut oil has some health benefits too, research shows that they are mainly due to its MCT oil content. Also consider that coconut oil contains potassium while MCT oil does not. Now, very important, how to take MCT oil for maximum benefits? The usual serving size for MCT oil is 1 tablespoon per day, which is around 15 grams. But according to all the studies I've talked about earlier, you just need about 5 to 10 grams of MCT a day to get all the benefits. That translates to around 1/2 tablespoon per day. A word of caution, do not start off with the recommended 1 tablespoon. Work your way up to it so that it doesn't cause stomach upset. Okay guys, time for the most powerful home remedy of today's video. Now, if you have heard about the incredible benefits of red wine for your kidney health, but you want to enjoy them without having to drink alcohol, which can be addictive and also can interact with several medications, try resveratrol supplements. Resveratrol is the powerful antioxidant found in grapes, the source of all red wine health benefits. According to multiple studies, resveratrol from supplements has cardiovascular, anti-carcinogenic, and anti-aging benefits. As an antioxidant, resveratrol can also be found in other foods. Actually, I made a video showing what some of the best sources of antioxidants are. It's up here if you're interested in improving your renal diet. Now, what you should know about resveratrol is that it has incredible and proven health benefits for people with kidney problems. And when it comes to fighting kidney disease, in vitro studies have shown positive effects of resveratrol in diabetic nephropathy. These include a reduction in glucose, insulin, HbA1c, cholesterol, triglycerides, and even creatinine and bone levels. Additional positive effects seen include a decrease in albuminuria, oxidative damage, and improvements in renal function. Now, these results are just amazing, and very interestingly, researchers think that resveratrol may lower your blood pressure and protect your kidneys because it increases nitric oxide production in the body. This may be why, just like spirulina, resveratrol has shown to have kidney protecting benefits that exceed those of a lower blood pressure. Yes, this is a powerful supplement. What not many people know about resveratrol is that much of the human research has used supplements that contain high levels of resveratrol. Red wine contains less than 30 milligrams of resveratrol per liter, or 34 oz, but most studies investigating the health benefits of resveratrol used 150 milligrams or more per day. This means that taking resveratrol as a supplement is way more powerful than drinking red wine. Actually, many supplements even come in dosages of 1000 or 1200 milligrams, but 500 milligrams a day is a more reasonable choice according to research. Remember that you need the approval of your doctor to use resveratrol if you take blood thinning medications. And be smart when it comes to supplements. Never start taking two or more supplements at once. Start with one at a time, take notes, and remember, the battle for kidney disease is a march, not a sprint. Okay guys, a new video is coming next Tuesday. In the meantime, keep taking good care of your kidneys and be good to yourself. This is all for today. Thank you for watching.